your Frank Brunos, your Herbie Hydes, and you know, he's just not big enough. And it's nice to see him back in his own division, even though it's probably taken a little bit of discipline for him to get there. What happens with fighters is they become lazy from a mental point of view of doing the weight, the discipline of eating the right food over a period of time and so forth, and he realised that he'd rather do that than suffer the big strength dependency that he'd suffer in fighting the heavyweights.
Uwe Ullmann doing the honours again. I'm not sure whether the German has actually given up his domestic heavyweight title. He was the German heavyweight champion. It was Marcus Pott. At least he was with Mike Murray for him.
He seems very laid back tonight.
But he was laid back before the Michael Murray fight. He got caught in his bottom several times.
I think in McGuinness tonight he fights a man who's 37 years old. And obviously won't be lacking in experience. With his left knee heavily strapped up. I don't know what sort of damage has been inflicted. It means road work or he's training for this particular contest. He's obviously confident he's in tip-top condition. Spot seems to me very, very casual, very laid back and confident.
He's had one fight since the Michael Murray fight, which was a sort of get your confidence back affair against a certain gentleman called Errol Ilter. That was in Minden, only 2 months after the hammering he got, and somewhat predictably, Bot won with a stoppage in round one. But this is a fair test.
Now Rick Enos has had 44 professional contests. He's obviously been around and seen all sorts of guys. And Marcus Bot won't show nothing new tonight from what he hasn't already seen.
Now he's got a very respectable record.
He's already tried one or two right hands over the rather lazy looking jab that Bot possesses, and you need to sharpen out if he's not to get nailed for that shot as the fight unfolds. Judging by the first round, this guy Enos has not come to lay down. He looks pumped up. Compete all the way for so it's been a bad opening round for Enos.
No, it certainly has not.
His work rate has been impressive and he's got through with one or two good clamping shots to the body. And so he's been ambitious, put the right hand over the top once or twice, which hasn't brought him no success as of yet. But Bot does really need to sharpen things up a little bit and try and gain some form of respect out of Enos.
Well, it's a good round. McInnes has been a pro for almost exactly 10 years longer than Marcus Bot. Turned pro in 79, did the American. Bot 10 years later. But there were some good fighters, most notably Dwight Muhammad Kawi, who stopped him in the round, and that really was the turning point. He'd built up a good record up to that point, but then run off the ball a little bit.
Nice pick up here. Did you see Bot trying to unload, but back comes the American with a good fighting uppercut to the belly, followed by one to the chin, and looking to land yet again. Finishing that combination. That's what he was stating earlier. He's, you know, he's firing all cylinders, the Yank, and he's looking to, he's not looking to make the numbers up, he's looking to get a result. From the German's point of view, it's good to see that they haven't brought someone over here to lie down for Bot. and build up the Paddy's record, bringing him back into the beginning field. This is a live wire tonight.
Well, there's no doubt that irrespective of whether he found waking them, making the waiting scene, Marcus Butt looks an awful lot more confident boxing up Cruz than at heavy. Looks far less apprehensive than he did against Michael Murray.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see once Butt starts to go to work, how Enes reacts under pressure. So far, he's been dictating the pace of the fight. It's been quite comfortable for him. I'd just like to see Butt sharpen things up and give the crowds that a cheer about, because they've certainly turned out in force to support him.
Yes, he's billed as coming from Hamburg, born in Pforzheim, but now lives in Hamburg. Ennis fancies this.
I don't think Bott's doing his case any favours by boxing in a shell, as he did for the most part of the first round, and he's now started again in this round. He's just too laid back, too lackadaisical in his approach, and not really being sharp and the governor, as they say. And he's letting this take the initiative.
German tending to ignore the basics. He's throwing a rather porky little left jab, doing much.
There's that right hand getting through for the first time successfully for Enes. He's tried it on a few occasions. The first time he's actually had success with it. And there was a uncomfortable wince from Bott when it landed.
Not like the body shot.
It's a good finish to the round.
Yeah, he's taking this round.
As soon as he gets the opportunity to bang him in, he doesn't hesitate.
End of round two. This is scheduled for 10. We're going to take a break. Join us back in Hamburg in a moment.
Eubank is
going to be high with you here in Hamburg.
Let's just see Enes leaning on Bott now. There he goes, as you see, over and over again. He bangs them body shots in before switching to the head, and that was a good quality left uppercut, which landed bang on the target.
And as you can see, third session. This is scheduled for 10. Marcus Bott in the black trunks with the white trim, and Rick Ennis in the all black and the blue boxing boots.
Now, this is the first time I've ever seen Bott in action, although I've seen his name on a regular basis over the years. He's obviously been around a good time. But he hasn't impressed me so far, so I'd just like to see what he does as he goes through the gears. He must be a lot better than what he's already shown, but he's starting to unload now, so maybe there could be proof in the pudding.
Ennis certainly is not overawed, however. Bott, all the hometown crowd. First two rounds, Jimmy. I've tried to score how a German judge might score it, which is proving to be difficult. I've made them even though Mahara Hearts, I think the American won them both.
Your scoring's been bang on just of late, so I'm not going to argue. Not forgetting the Germans boxed on home territory.
Well, that's what I mean.
I think even if they're being friendly tools, and the best they could have given up the opening two was a draw.
Well, that's what I'm getting at.
But he's starting to slip up the gear now, so maybe he may start to take over. Time will tell. Shank works when he gets closer. He really does sink them body shots in. It's obviously years of working in American gyms, the old shoe shining routine as they call it, and really does look comfortable at close quarters. But Watts needed to do what he's doing, up the pace to start forgetting about as much posing and unloading quality shots, trying to take over. Because at the end of the last round, Enis went back to the corner with a big smile on his face. That's more like it from Bot. Starting to put them together, trying to dictate the shape of the fight. Turn into a bruising tussle.
I think it will. I think it will. Could come down to fitness and desire at the end. And another defeat for Marcus Bott would be hugely damaging to his career. You see, he'd still be a domestic champion, but his credibility on a world basis would be sub-zero.
I just thought Bott got up through the gears in that round, and to be sort of critical, if you like, he doesn't seem that far superior technically than Rick Enis, and I think this could turn into a bit of a tussle now, because Enis fancied the job when he got in there. I'm sure he fancies it more now.
Incidentally, just to break away from the subject of this fight for a minute, thank you all of you who've written some very nice letters about the fight we had, that controversial fight, James Toney and Mike McCallum, the body snatcher, on Screen Sport a couple of weeks ago, when Baron McGuigan and myself both made McCallum a clear winner. Oh, I'm sorry, Jimmy Mann, beg your pardon, mate. We made McCallum a clear winner, did we not? And some of the newspaper reports you might have read suggested that Toney might have been a little hard done by. We reckon that McCallum was robbed, and it seems that a lot of people who've written to us, written to the boxing magazines, think that McCallum was the winner, Jim.
Yeah, I don't think there was no doubt about it whatsoever. Mike McCallum's been a great, great, great fighter, and it's a tragedy. One, he's been stripped of his WBA title, and two, he never secured the IBF because he certainly won it on merit.
Anyway, enough of that. Back in Hamburg for round four, the scheduled 10-rounder, Marcus Bott versus Rick Enis.
Professional experience, Rick Enis actually doubles up on what Bott has learned or achieved in his 16 fights. And it'd be interesting to see if he could bring that experience to light tonight, because his fight, as I stated earlier, doesn't seem a lot in it in terms of technical ability. They both seem to have plenty of desire, and it'd be interesting to see which becomes the deciding factor.
I have to say that both men are essentially very one-paced, but as we saw against Michael Murray, Bott is such a tough, strong man. You know, he can break your heart.
Maybe that could be the ingredient that pulls out from tonight. He's starting to become ambitious and starting to throw shots. And when he puts them together, he looks the part. But as you said, he tends to become one pace and switches on and off like a tap. This has been his best round for me so far.
Easily, Jim, easily.
Starting to dominate. Starting to look the faster, quicker, sharper fighter of the two. And what he needs to do now is maintain it. That's more like it than Bott.
Oh, that was very low. That was very low.
I think we might get a time out here because got struggling. And certainly the antagonism of his body was struck.
Yes, that was...
which inflicts that type of pain, so...
That was not so much below the belt, it was just above the knee, that one. And in some discomfort, the German. He can quite legitimately claim a timeout until he recovers.
Enos looking to his corner, taking the moment to take a
I don't
bit of
think he's
advice.
Allowed to get treatment from the corner. I'm sure he has to recover by himself. And what happened was the foul protector protects you against a blow that is delivered straight on, but this one was a sort of hook, and it jammed the foul protector up into the German's groin and brings tears to your eyes, believe me.
I'm sure there was no malice or intent.
Oh, no, no, no. Absolutely part. Not.
Just
absolutely not.
In the heat at the moment,
I'm
straight
sure
low. Referee giving him a little bit of a ticking
he's
off.
He's taking a point off.
But he's an old pro, you know, and...
I'm sure you'll see a touch of gloves when this restarts. I'm sure you will. There you go. That's nice to see. But Ennis has had 1 point deducted for a low blow. And if he does it again, he'll be out.
That's it, spot in front on my scorecard now, because say the last round was very impressive. And Ennis would have to win this round big to get a draw in this particular round.
Oh, right on the belt. Good exchange right on the belt.
The fight's starting to liven up, Dave. It's become a little bit sticky at the start, but now it's beginning to unfold and look the part.
We'll take a look at that foul punch in a moment. But you see, Bob is marking off a little bit under the eyes. His face is going very red.
So he's sustained a slight bruise under the right eye as well, kind of a little bit yellowy. And massage to the nose, obviously, for the bruising.
And it's okay.
That is Frank Turner working in McEnus's corner.
Matchroom matchmaker. Let's take a look at this foul again.
Well, all through the contest, as I stated earlier, Ian's been throwing loads of body shots, and here you see as they lean on one another, he's still going about the same game plan, but that one,
ouch,
the right hand,
ouch,
has gone lower than low.
Oh.
And rightly so,
oh.
Bot was given the timeout.
Wince City. Round 5. Schedule for 10.
You say to Marcus Bot, Wince City, he'll say, tell me about it.
Not surprisingly, Ennis concentrating almost exclusively on jabs to the head right now. Good textbook jabs. And look at him jerking Bot's head back. Beautiful, right out of the textbook.
I'll tell you what, he wants to go into overdrive with that, because that looks a great weapon. And could be very successful for him, because he seems to hit Bot with it. Bang on. And let's not forget at the end of the last round, he caught him with a cracking right hand as well, so the signs are there. Try and put it together. Bot's features look highly swollen, his nose is swollen, his left eye's got a bruise coming out underneath it, so Enos is a plenty of success, let's not forget that.
And there's blood somewhere, there's blood on the German's neck. Now, where is that coming from, I wonder?
Bot looks to me as if he can step the pace up when he chooses, because he takes a few shots.
Ennis must be cut.
To give him a kick up the backside. I think he's out of his nose, actually, Dave. You see a slight leakage as he spam round above us.
Correct. Well done, Jim. Only 5 of Bot's previous 16 contests have gone the distance.
I just wonder if he books his throw as durable and he's saving himself and pacing himself out for the second half
he
of the contest.
He just grinds you down, Jim.
Yeah, he looks the grindy down top on it.
If you look at his record, the fights he's won through stoppage have all been in the last 2 or 3 rounds. So sometimes a lot of them in the very last round.
Well, maybe that's what his game plan is tonight. Slow wearing down process. He certainly looks that type of fire. There's no fluency in Pot's work, it's all, everything seems an effort.
Raw power. And it's much better mover.
And it looks to me at the moment as if he's gone a little bit tired. I don't know if that's a tribute to the fact that Bot's now stepped the pace up. And he's looking to unload with both hands. And he's not coming back with the same type of fire he was around a tour ago. A little bit concerned about his nose as he goes back to the corner as well. Good
don't
round
forget,
for Bot.
Absolutely, Jim. Don't forget, those of you watching this, that the American had a point deducted in the last round for a low blow, albeit accidental, but a low blow it was.
The gloves in the corner. Let's just pick up the action here. You see this impressive jab we were speaking about earlier. Find it to the chest more than to the face. In our camera shot here, but there's a good one straight through to the head of Bot. And maybe Enis should concentrate a little bit more on that left hand because it brought him success at the beginning of the round. And he kept Bot from getting set, kept him off balance. He proved to have been a real match winner for the American if he could do more of it.
Yes, I think you'd have to say that Bot was in front without looking particularly impressive.
Yeah, he's starting to take over now. He's starting to look the part. He's starting to feel he is the governor. And now he's, looks like he's put his foot on the accelerator. I don't know if that's orders from the corner. But he's now the man in
control. That was a good right uppercut.
He's getting accurate with the shots now as well. He's not wasting shots as he was earlier in the fight.
American bleeding quite heavily from the nose now.
Yeah, that can be a real hindrance when your nose is bleeding, it goes into your mouth. It's very, very difficult to breathe.
And one good right hand from Enis did get through, right on the target.
I don't think, as strong as Bot is, he ain't what you call a defensive genius, and he does get nailed. And obviously, as he goes up in class, I believe he'd get fanned out.
Well, he's got a hell of a good chin. Murray had him down 3-4 times, and he always got up.
You know, this is two honest professionals going about a tough bruising encounter. There's made no mistake, both of them. Look at that, what uppercut he's got. Out comes the gun shield. Both of them have all full blasted shots, and Bot looks the fresher. Stronger.
Yes, Bot is looking to do a job now.
Yeah, he's really the fatigue is setting for Enis now. And that nose of his isn't helping.
But the American at times a bit like a cornered, wounded wild animal. He can still hurt you, he can still fight back, and that's what he's doing.
Tremendous return.
Oh, it's on right hand, and that has hurt Bot.
It's turning into a cracking fight now. Started off a little bit slowly, but both fighters have now injected the pace.
Whoop, and it's out the ring. That was a slip.
The German corner instructing Bot furiously to maintain the pace. I believe they feel the Americans tiring. I think they're right. That's more like it from Bot.
It's been a good round for Bot, but funnily enough, it hasn't been a bad round for the American.
It's been a good round, it's been a hard round. What's going to come out of this round, David? He recovers. better from that type of output, because there was a lot of energy expended on both parts, and there's still a few rounds to go just yet.
I thought Bott might have just shaded it, but my goodness, Ennis got some telling blows.
I've just been instructed by Irby that our American friend is enjoying it so much that he's come back to the corner with a big smile on his face.
Well, our friend Rick Spain, is he back? Oh, I can see him. I can see him there. Yeah, we can't see Rick Spain. He's hidden behind a pillar. Just quietly watching. Ennis is having a good time. Bott's having a good time.
And the crowd are now having a good time. They're enjoying
it. Everyone's having a good time. We're seeing the hometown boy doing well.
Yeah, he's in the driving seat now. He's dictating the pace. He's taken over. And he's got a determined foe in front of him. He'll box there and fight right to the last. I think Bott's now starting to look impressive.
Now, what is happening in the Ennis corner? The bell has gone for the start of round seven. Now, the referee, I can't see anything. Has he stopped it? No, he's called a timeout. He's unhappy about something, Uwe Ullmann, but I'm not quite sure what, Jim.
I wasn't sure if they're having difficulty in mopping up the excess blood that was leaking from his nose. But, I'm sure it won't take long to start leaking again, because Bott's now letting shots go with both hands. But the pace has really lifted. It was a little bit pedestrian early on, but now they're both in top gear. Blood is absolutely leaking in the American's nose.
Yeah, that can indicate a broken nose. And of course, as we've often said on Pro Box, you can't breathe through your nose, so your mouth comes open, and you're
very,
not getting a
very,
broken
very
jaw.
Very difficult. The situation that I found myself in myself, and I can speak from experience that it's very, very uncomfortable to try and breathe and box and stay composed. The Americans giving it a good try. I'll tell you what, though, for a 37-year-old man, the man's in tip-top condition, because he hasn't flagged, and the pace has been, the last couple of rounds especially, pretty warm. At one stage, he looked like he shot his bolt, but back he comes to prove everyone wrong. I'm sure he's won Bott's respect if he never had it when he climbed in there.
But Bott is the sort of tough hombre who just gets stronger as the fight goes on. In comes Ennis. Oh, that was a bit cute by the referee.
All the beauty of boxing in your hometown.
Now that really was, that was a little bit naughty by Uwe Ullmann. Bott was on the receiving end of a good attack, and he stops it and then criticises Bott for holding, which he wasn't.
What we're really saying is best fighting the beast.
Yes. All right, you said it, Jim. That was a push, no knockdown. Oh, come on, referee. That's absurd. That is absurd. The crowd are whistling. That is absolutely rotten refereeing. I'm sorry to have to say it, but that is just rank bad refereeing.
Rick Enos looked at him there as if to say, is your name Jeremy Beadle? You've got to be out going for a laugh, because...
And that, Mr. Ullmann, is the bet.
That was a tough round for the American, apart from having the difficulty of the referee making it even tougher.
Well, I had thought he'd been refereeing this contest quite well up to now, but that round, that was daft. Now, here's this little flurry by the American. And you see, doing really well. And he pushes him over. And the referee takes the count up. That's absurd.
It's the first fight I've ever seen counted for going on the floor from throwing too many punches himself. Maybe the referee thinks he landed one of his own. Certainly weren't nothing coming from Bot.
Do you get the feeling this isn't Rich Knight?
Absolutely. I'm looking at Bot's corner now, Dave, and the guy's obviously in tremendous condition because he's relaxed, arms on the rope, still got plenty left. And for Enis, he looks to me on his last legs at this stage. You know, I stated earlier that he still looked good, but he's, you know, he's absorbed quite a few shots. And the blood is not helping
Hello.
His case.
What's Marcus?
I just wonder if they're retiring him.
I think he's quitting on his stool. Yeah.
I think it's his corner. I think the man's going to pull him out. And,
well, we're looking at Frank Turner, who's just above us. Can't see what's happening. Is Enis?
Well, won't be a bad decision if they do pull him out, because he's behind and starting to absorb shots now.
Yeah, I think he has.
Yeah.
I think he has.
Looks a formality now.
Bot goes over to Harry and says, I've won, ref. And the crowd, well, they're not a hometown crowd, they like to see their boy win, Jim, but they like to see him do it in style.
Well, I think what it is, Dave, as well, I think they've taken their hat off to the American for the way he's gone about his work. He hasn't come here to lay down or make numbers up. He's gone in there determined, he's competed on an even kill all the way through. It's only over the last couple of rounds that Bot's really taken over and started looking the dominant force. But not an over-impressive performance from Bot.
No, I have to say,
to put it in a nutshell.
Funnily enough, I think he was winning without the ref putting his oar in. But the manner of the victory was unsatisfactory, and Enis fought very well.
I don't think, you know, at the end of the day, a win's a win, but I don't think Bot's going to be celebrating for too long over this particular victory, because it was very, very a workmanlike performance. And he had to sort of dig deep against someone he would have been expected to have beat comfortably if he was looking at him as a red hot prospect of the future.
So Uwe Ullmann will do the formalities. It'll go down as a TKO, but we know it better as a retirement. Enis retired on his stool at the end of round 7. The winner is Marcus Bott.